Okay, so very nice answer. Your command continue. So half wave rectifier and a full wave rectifier. So only half, okay, half wave only conduction. Remaining half wave is not conduction. Okay, it's a remaining half wave is a zero. Full wave conduction means both the input is of a positive magnitude as well as negative magnitude is conducted. You can write about that one. So only half of the magnitude. So only, okay, half magnitude. Okay, half magnitude is conducted. Okay. So what about here means both, okay, both okay, positive as well as negative magnitude. So both magnitude is a conduct. Okay, so here is a two diode is used, here is a four diode is used, diode resistance is high as well as transformer is used, so that's why it is a high cost. This is the low cost, cheapest one. Efficiency wise, this is a very lowest efficiency. This is efficiency is very high. The next one, very good, ripple factors. So which one is ripple factor is high? So ripple factor is which one is high? So half wave is high or full wave is high? So full wave ripple factor is high. What about the no, it's a ripple factor is a just it is a efficiency opposite. So it's a 0.4, it's a point, it's a triple times 1.2. so 1.2 times of that ripple factors. So it is just it is a reverse. So it is a ripple factors. Am I correct? Can I get the response? Yes. Yes. So ripple factor, yes. One of the student is answered. Very good. So ripple factor, yes, yes, yes. Good. So easy to you can remember. So efficiency here is low and here is high. So just it is opposite. This is a ripple factor is low. That this one is a ripple factor is high. Just opposite. Okay. So easy to you will going to remember about the concept. Okay, sorry, I write it on the tone. Okay, ripple factor, like you will go to differentiation and draw the waveform. Okay, this is about the differentiations. Another one is here is a no classification about that one. Half wave means, so only half wave diode is used. Half wave diode only possible. So diode rectifier, okay, or half wave diode rectifier only used. But when you have go for that one, there are types, okay, classified. So classified into that one. So classified into two types. So you will go and write about that one. Two types it has that one. One is a center tapped. Okay, center tapped. Another one is a you will going to use the bridge rectifier. So like about that one, it will go to classify. Okay, good. So next one will go for that one. This is up to now is about that rectifier half wave and full wave we are so far covered. Okay, next one will go for that one is a three-phase rectifier. Okay, three-phase rectifier. What is a three-phase rectifier? Okay, what is that there? Three-phase full wave rectifier. Why do I want to go for that three-phase full wave rectifier? So why do I want to go means if your rectification output DC is needed more. So rectifier means same AC to DC conversions. So rectifier means what? AC to DC conversion is called rectifier. If you want more DC output is more. Okay, so your V naught output is you need more means so more output. So you can go for that. Three-phase rectifier. That's all. So three-phase rectifier, you will going to produce more DC output. Okay. For example, I will going to operate for that three-phase. I will going to operate for that DC motor. I want to operate my DC motor. For example, laboratory. If you are going to operate the laboratory of the motors, so it is needed for that one. Is it 220 voltage is needed? So 220 voltage DC voltage is needed. V naught is equal to 220. So how do you going to give this much of the higher rating? So you can go for that three-phase full wave rectifier and current rating. So current rating I naught is equal to, for example, it is a 5 amps. So 5 amps. What is the output of the power? So P naught is equal to what is answer? 220 multiply 5. What is answer? So this is about the motor output of the power required. What is answer? Someone just now they are joined. I will going to make the admit. Yes. Screen is visible. Yes. Yes. Screen is visible. Yes. Tell me. What is output of the powers? 220 multiply 5. 1100 watt. So 1100 watt is you will going to apply 1100 watt. Okay. So what is the HEP wise? One HEP is equal to what is the one HEP? One HEP is equal to what? 746 or 765 they will come to. Okay, 746. So this one divided by 746, what is the answer? So 1100 by 746, it is equal to 1.4. You will going to convert it into the watt, into the HP. So what is HP of this motor? 1.4 HP, or roughly they will going to say, okay, they will going to say about that one, approximately they will say 1.5 HP motor. So the motor is a 1.5 HP motor. So this type of the highest rating means you need to go for that 3-phase full wave rectifier. Okay, coming to that one, 3-phase full wave rectifier means same AC input and DC output. But here input is AC is a, okay, 3-phase is applied as an input. The next question. So what is the phase angle of the 3-phase power supply? What is the phase angle? 120 degree. How this 120 degree? R to Y is a 120. Y to B is a 120. Then B to R is a 120. This is a important. Suppose R to Y is a 120. R to B is what is answer? So here I will go and write. R to B, what is answer? R to B, can I get the answer from you firstly? R to B, what is answer? 120 plus 120. 120 plus 120. It is equal to, what is answer? 240. Yes. So this is answer about that one. 120. 240. What is that one? Okay, here is a R to B. So okay, R to B about that ones. So here you will going to actually why it is needed. If I see about your equation, so V A N V B N V C N, another one is V A B V B N. I will going to open your PPT, then you will going to use it, you will going to understand. So yes. So if I have seen that one, where it is equations. Yes. So here you have see that one, V A N, first phase to neutral, second phase to neutral, third phase to neutral. So what is this one here? So it's a 0 degree. Okay, 120 degree. What is 120? So 2 pi. Where is the calculator is available? Okay, I will take your calculator. Okay, so what is that one? I want to show you. So 2 pi, 2 into pi for that 180, okay, divided by 3. So what is the answer? It is a 120. See that one, 120. So R, okay, R to B is the angle is a 120. B to C is what is angle? It is a 120. But total is what is angle? 2. Okay, 120 plus 120, 240. So 4 into 180 divided by 3. What is answer? 240. So this is angle. So now coming to the Word document. Okay, 240. So this is a, now you may understand 0, 120, 240. It's angle differentiations. Angle differentiations. Then VAB is equal to, so VAN minus VBN. So you will going to subtract it. Then you will going to get the answers. Then VBC. So VBN minus CN. So similarly VCA. VCN minus VAN. So you are going to get the answers. Okay. So coming to here. Okay. So this is about, okay, then further you will going to see about that input waveform. How about input waveform look like? This is an input waveform. So whatever we are going to discuss, this is a we will discuss. So 0 to 120 or 0 to 240 for the next phase. So like we were written, okay. Okay, then next one. So how many diodes are used on the 3-phase full wave rectifier? How many diodes there are used? There are totally 6 diodes are the uses. 6 diodes. Okay. What is the angle of conduction? Each diode of 3-phase. What is the angle of conduction of each diode? Each diode angle conduction is 120 degree only. 120 degree. What is that one? 120 degree only. Each diode is conducted. Each diode is conducted. Angle is a 120. Very good. Very good. Student is answering. Yes. 120 degree only. Okay. Next one. How? You will going to coming to know that one. Next question answers. How? Why only 120 degree? What is the proof? So what is the mode of the operation of the modes or sequence of 3-phase full wave rectifier? Yes, come on, firstly you can type in the chat box. I will going to type it here. 6, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6. This is sequence of operations. Now you can look at, so what is the each mode of the, what is the conduction of, what is conduction of each mode of three-phase full wave rectifier? Three-phase full wave rectifier. Tell me. So what is each mode conduction? Each mode conduction is a 60 degree. Each mode is conduction is a 60 degree. This is also 60. Okay, this is also 60. Another one, this is also 60. Every mode is conducted angle is a 60. If I have see that one is conducted here, one is conducted here. So one diode one is a 60 plus 60, totally 120. Similar two is conducted here, 60 plus 60, 120. That's why I have written as a 120. Each diode is conduction angle is a 120. Okay, what is the angle? Okay, next question. Okay, what is that one? So every time how many number of diode is connected? So every mode, how many number of diodes? Okay, how many number of diodes conduct means, what is that every mode, how many diodes? Two diode, what is the method it is conducted? The two diode, what is the method is conducted? One from upper and one from lower. So like it is conducted, one from upper and one from lower. Okay, then next one. Okay, so what is that one number sequence? Okay, what is number sequence on upper layer, upper and bottom layer of diodes? What is the number sequence? So upper is the odd number. Upper is odd number. So what is odd number? 1, 3, 5. Okay, bottom is what is number? Bottom is even number. Very good. No, answer is not correct. Your answers, the two should not be start first. So what is the even number means? What is that one? Even number start from the 2, 4, 6, 8. But start from that one, first number you can erase it. What is the second one? 4, 4, 6, 2. This is sequence. It is conducted. Why? Because of the conductions. Okay. So this is a place of the first diode. Then after that, this is a place. What is that one diode to another diode? First, what is the difference between the one diode to another diode means? 60 degree angle differentiation. So that's why. What is the conduction of each diode, each modes of that one? So what is the, what is the difference between, so what is the difference, what is the angle difference between, D1 to D2 means, what is the angle between D1 to D2, similarly D2 to D3, what is the angle between these two? So like you can continue, similarly D3, so what is the angle between D3 to D4? What is the angle between that ones? So 60 degree. So that is important. 60 degree angle between D1 to D2. So D2 conducted after 60 degree D3. D3 conducted after 60 degree D4. Okay. Then next one. Okay. What is the period of conductions? So what is the period? Period of conduction. Conduction of each modes. Very important. What is the period of conduction of each mode? Tell me. So what is the period of conduction of each mode? So take this one. I am going to give, there are the six mode of the sequence. Okay. So what is that one? First one, come on, firstly you can respond me. First one, when it is conducted? Starting from 0 or 30 degree. 30 plus 60. What is answer? 90. The next one, 90 plus 60 is equal to what is answer? 90 plus 60, 150. The next one, 150 plus 60, what is answer? 210. Then 210, okay, 210 plus 60, what is answer? 270. 270 plus 60, plus 60, what is answer? 330. So 330 plus 60, what is answer? 390. 390 means one cycle is completed. One cycle means 360. Plus 30. So why mode 1 question? Okay, why mode 1 start from 30 degree instead of 0? Tell me. Because previously conducted modes.